Microsoft Copilot is changing, and those changes are going to have big impacts. And that's because not so long ago, Microsoft Copilot was released. We saw potential that we could use this app to do a lot of our work for us. It could be your digital personal assistant at a very low price. But the problem came, well, if you were looking at it from the workplace, you would have to sign a check for a few hundred thousand dollars to Microsoft to access Copilot, meaning for most, well, it was just out of reach. And what if you had a personal version of Microsoft 365 at home? Could you use Copilot? Well, in theory, you could use free versions, but you couldn't use them integrated inside of your Microsoft apps at home. Again, Microsoft Copilot was out of reach. But things are changing, meaning that we're now going to have options to access those tools. And what I'm going to show you is some of those capabilities and how we can use them, and also those changes you can take advantage of today. And before we dive in, if you want to know more about Copilot, well, why not subscribe to our channel? We have a huge amount of content already covered, and also content coming up to cover more about how Copilot can work for you and save you all those important hours. So anyway, let's dive into Copilot and check out what's upcoming. So you're probably wondering, well, where are the big changes? Well, the first is that Microsoft 365 is now available for any business customers. Yes, the 300 user requirement that we had previously has now disappeared. And if you run a small business and use licensing like Business Standard or Business Premium, well, the good news is you can also buy Copilot. That now means you can take advantage of Copilot today, purchase a license, and look to save all of that time through things like drafting emails, finding files easier, and also creating content in apps like OneNote, PowerPoint, and Word. And we're able to do that without breaking the bank and signing checks for hundreds of thousands of dollars. And not only that, another big change is coming. We now have a new product. That's called Copilot Pro. I'm sure Microsoft didn't want to feel left out when you're using the Pro brand, especially considering Apple have already used that for quite a while. And Copilot, well, he's taking that tagline. This new product set is available for home, personal, and family subscriptions of Microsoft 365, meaning you can now have Copilot added into your subscription at an additional cost of $20 per user per month, allowing you to use the great capabilities that we see in the business on the apps that you have at home. Yes, you'll now be able to use apps like Microsoft Word, OneNote, and PowerPoint, and use files that are stored in your family subscription and create content and have emails summarized inside of your personal version of Outlook. So if you need help on an assignment, a piece of homework, or need to write a professional letter, well, Copilot at home under the new Copilot Pro is going to help you achieve that. So those changes are going to be really significant in how we're going to view Copilot, because now it's available to the masses, where previously it wasn't. So with that in mind, what can Copilot do for you? Let's check out a few scenarios to see how we can create content really easily in Copilot you can take advantage of with these new licensing models. So how about Microsoft Word? Well, when we've got access to Copilot, we can have it create some new ideas for us. So in this case, we need some taglines for a new dessert cookbook we're creating. And all I need to do is ask Copilot to generate those ideas. And much like we've seen in things like ChatGPT, it can come up with those ideas really quickly, but there's no more need to copy and paste from those apps and bring it into Word. No, as we can see, that content is directly inserted inside of Microsoft Word. We can then open the Copilot sidebar inside of Microsoft Word, and we can now ask it to make some changes to the content it's created and come up with some new ideas that we can copy into the document later. So using Copilot, we can change the content that's been created and begin to refine it, taking away those pain points of looking at a blank Word document and working what comes next. But it doesn't end there, because I spend a lot of time converting Word documents into PowerPoints. It takes hours for me every single week. We can have Copilot help us out on that. In that scenario, the dessert cookbook we've created with those ideas can be converted easily into a PowerPoint presentation that Copilot can create. Yes, all we need to do is point Copilot using the PowerPoint app to create a PowerPoint from that Word file we've just created. It'll go ahead and integrate with tools like Microsoft Designer and create a new professional presentation using the Copilot integration. And what about inside of Outlook? Well, we can have it summarize emails from email threads in your personal version of Outlook. And not only that, we can also begin creating content in Outlook as well. Yes, if you need to draft a new email for a professional purpose, well, why not have Copilot help you out? All we need to do is give it the information we need inside of that email. Go ahead, and Copilot can even generate the content and change the sentiment of the email, meaning we can save again all of that time creating all important emails and sharing them with the people you need. So Microsoft Copilot is certainly mixing things up. There are just a couple of scenarios that you can use in the new Copilot experience when we're looking at it through the lens of Copilot Pro. But not also forgetting that Microsoft 365 Copilot for use in businesses will provide even more opportunities to save people time. The only thing we do mention is just being careful in the business not to enable it for everyone without ensuring all of your data is well protected and secured to the right people in your environment. And if you need to know more about that, well, feel free to reach out and see how we can help. Otherwise, I'd be interested in finding out how you feel about the new changes to Microsoft Copilot and whether you'll be hitting on the buy button to buy all those important licenses or holding off for a little bit longer. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in the next one.